Back from that short break, and of course you're still watching Urban Today right here on Urban Television. Now on our Kachai this morning, we're going to be talking about a 10 or the tithe that you're supposed to give out in church right there. Everyone on this planet Earth is obligated to actually be giving out something to the church. Yeah. According to the Bible, you're supposed to get a chekumi, not your own church. So how about those of us who actually take the money and those of us who do not take the money? Yeah, now I'm confusing some of you, but anyway, may I pay my tithe? So we're going to be discussing tithe this particular morning.
I'm going to be confusing Arabi. Otugambi, iwama mubusira mutechiriyo. Kati otugamba
yu. No, tuina zaka.
Kati zaka. Zaka. Faruku, wana atufera wa tatufera?
Afera.
Of course, Faruku. Faruku just ampala na
vwala. Akuwala na, hey. Yene maso, tujite. Tujite.
Nina haki nya. Eh? Aina bili, kata ampala na. Tuwagala kutaithi banange, omugaso gw'okuwa taithi chichi.
Taithi yamba nyo. Taithi, it's like, first of all, an expression of faith. In you believe. Because it's easy for you to say, I believe in God. Hiya nga tuli kukacha ino, I believe in God. Yeah. Newa chituka ku, to go that extra step and properly believe. Abamu kufi, abakristayo. Kule melelwa. No tunula no gamba milioni 10 nzifunye omwezi.
Nziweyo.
Kwate milioni namba. Kusane nseke mu envelope. Ngende. Bagenti tithi bayimba kayimba ngende. Ntambule na kakade kange mu nsawo. Nkatwale and I put it in a basket with pubu. And go back home.
Yeah.
It's hard for some people. But if you believe in God, if you believe in God and make that first step, and you know, put that tithe there. Trust me, you'll do things in, and eventually it will become a habit that you never change. So yeah, tithe is important.
It becomes a part of you. Like when I first started tithing, I it was the small amount, you know, because I had less, I was earning less then. And it was kind of not easy even then. That's why for me, the metaphor didn't really link up. 300,000, 300 million. At whatever stage in life you're at, whatever you're earning, it is hard to part with. That's what I believe. It's very hard to part with. But then as you get used to it, you get used to it. And then you see the benefits of it. Because some of the benefits of tithe, if you do read the book that I eventually did put down, when you read the book, it says, whatever that you have, if you give me what belongs to me, I will bless you in ways, not just for your generation, but the generations to come after you. You get, so you may pay tithe in January and expect blessings by end of Feb. He don't work like that. You could pay tithe in January and the blessing will be upon your child.
But you can also pay tithe on Sunday as you're getting out of church.
That is also possible. But you see, that's the thing. He works in his...
But you see, it's very easy for someone to pay taxes.
But had to pay tithe. Because of believers' faith.
No, because also open tithe, God is not going to say, okay, tompa de tithe, ngena kusiba, ogena kufa, ogena kuluara, bichibichi. No. Whereas government will put you in prison, they'll put your name in papers, they will embarrass you in public. So you're like, ha, let me pay these guys their money. You don't know what it's going to do. Actually, you know it's going to do.
It's a personal initiative. It is between you and your God. Whether you believe in him, there are times I would call him, I'm like, Naihoman, look at me and he's like, if only you knew that.
Those are the people you find in churches who go to, you know, find wives, who go to make business deals in church.
They're not really there to pray.
Look for husbands and whatnot. They're not there to pray.
It's just social gathering. The
word. Yeah, because God says, my word is the food. You understand? If you listen to it, you'll get satisfied. And, you know, you think about all these things and say, you know what? I think it's important to pay tithe.
We are living in a world or situation whereby we give, you know, these pastors our money, but at the end of the day, they use them for their personal gain. So if I'm to give them my tithe.
What define personal gain?
Personal gain is, you know, building these luxurious houses, driving, you know, luxurious cars.
Tithe goes in a pool of a church. When it goes in a pool of a church, one of the pillars of the church is the pastor or the priest, the father, So that's one of the pillars of the church. There has to be a head, someone with a vision or whatnot.
So it is okay for them to in order for them to not do
other businesses, to concentrate on the word of God, to concentrate on feeding you the sheep, indiga. Okubaweze ekigambo kya Mukama bulungi abenga ali focused. Asibe nakwana, aveya abasabire, asabire gwanga, asabire delika, asabire tina, asabire abalema, asabire bani. They have to leave.
So it is a core part of the Bobitan and Pastor.
No,
Pastor,
I think that analogy I feel for me is wrong. At the end of the day, you have to understand that when you pay tithe, according to the Bible, you're not paying it to your pastor, you're not paying it to your preacher or whatever, you're paying it to the Lord. Now, that is not on you. If you have paid your tithe to the Lord, how your preacher
uses it,
misappropriates it or uses it, that is also on him. Now the onus is on you to make sure you have played your part, right? After you played your part,
tithe ya kuzimba kanisa, CV ya kola chini. Bible techogera. Teka mnyumba ya Mukama.
There you have it. So at this point in time, I'm going to go in for a very small breather. But when we do get back, we shall be having a guest joining us. And we shall be talking about the weather in the country.